Hi everyone, it's the English Simmer here, and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 4 Part 50. I cannot believe that we are on Part 50 of this Let's Play. So, I was just playing through the night, as I do usually, to set up for this part, and remind me to never invite BJ to a party ever again, because as you can see from this little moodlet down here, there is a fire, and the Sims must extinguish fires or flee them. Everyone's really tense because there's a fire, and it's all thanks to frickin' BJ. I don't even know what he did. He must have tried to make a flaming drink, and he's gonna go extinguish it. He's screaming fire. She's screaming fire. She's screaming fire. Everyone else is just screaming fire, and Avery's the only one to extinguish it. Can we, like, call the fire brigade or what? I don't even know, but holy, he can find a route to safety. Can all of these find a route to safety? They can, but I want Avery to put it out. Find a route to safety. You find a route to safety. Can we actually call the fire brigade? I don't think we can. I've never had a fire in this game. I don't know what to do. Emma, I want you to find a route to safety as well. Avery, you can extinguish it. Come on. Come on, buddy. You can do this. BJ, you were the one who did this. I blame it all on you. Like, what the hell? Guys, get to safety. Okay, they're all fleeing that way. That's so annoying. The Kranks have received 320 as an insurance payment for the items that were damaged. Okay, so they're all outside because they all sprinted outside. And Avery's just walking around like, hell yeah, I'm a firefighter. Bravely extinguishing a blaze really boosts the Sim's confidence. So he's super happy with himself, but I'm gonna send everyone back to bed. I'm sorry, Louise, but you can starve. I guess you can use the bathroom before you go back to sleep. Everyone, just please go back to sleep. Really couldn't be bothered with that. I don't even know why that happened. He was actually meant to be going home, but instead he just decided to start a fire on our lot. So annoying. Fire is out. Thank goodness the fire is over. Could it have been any worse? No, I really don't think it could have been. Well, it could have been. It could have like ruined a whole lot and that would have been a lot worse, but thankfully it wasn't. So everyone's heading in and heading back to bed. BJ, please leave. I do not want you in our house any longer. You are a walking disaster. First time we invite him to a party, he starts mi mixing drinks in Speedos. Like, that is not what you do. That is gross. You should never do that. And two, he starts a fire. Like, are you kidding me? I don't even know how he did it, but I'm gonna send all the Sims back to bed. I just wanted to record that because I'd never seen a fire in The Sims 4 and I thought it was kind of hilarious that they all just ran. Oh, this is 800 simoleons to replace. Oh well. I'm gonna replace it because we have the money. It's not like we're poor. But yeah, I'm gonna skip through this again and I'll be back with you guys in the morning once all the Sims have woken up. Alright guys, so everyone's just waking up right now. Avery actually has work today. I should probably invite round. Oh, someone just downloaded Crank. I should probably invite round Johnny and Mateo. I should probably age them up because Louise is now a young adult. That happened in the last part. So I think we should invite them round to maybe age those up so she can obviously still be friends with them and still be in a relationship with Mateo. And I also moved Tom's grave, or not his gravestone, but it was his urn, and I just moved it outside and it automatically turns into a gravestone for all those ones who wanted to know. I think we should probably place some flowers on him, though. I think that would be quite cool. I did not mean to press terrain. I want flowers and that's a lot of flowers. Are there any like smaller bunches? Those kind of don't look like the type of flowers that you put on there. Can these daisies go this way? Do they look any? Nope, they're still as wide. Oh well. We'll just stick these here. I should probably put move objects on, but oh well. There we go. So now he has some daisies on his gravestone, and they can mourn him, and they can release his spirit to the netherworld. But I know it's a bit harsh, but I kind of want to keep his spirit here for a bit. So Avery, you can stop washing your hands. Everyone should really be getting up. Louise is still asleep. She's feeling a range of emotions. She's sad from mourning, she's inspired, she's uncomfortable, and she's tense. She has so many different emotions running through her right now. She's like still a hormonal teenager. How are you doing, kiddo? You do have work today. I was going to keep her off school, but then I was like, you know what? She may as well go in. Like, there's not that much point of keeping her off. Tomorrow is a Saturday. She should have probably done her homework because she might go down a grade. I really don't want her to. I want her to be on an A when she ages up. So I'm just going to have her start her homework and she can just do as much as she can before she actually has to go to school. You, I want you to be energized, dammit. Why are you so focused? I wanted him to be energized so the likelihood of us getting a promotion would increase, but he's not feeling it. He's just feeling extremely focused. We can probably turn off the emotional auras that we... I don't even know where the focused one comes from anymore. Do we still have that painting on our wall? Okay, yeah. We're gonna disable, and hopefully that'll mean that this area isn't so focused, because the reason we only had that was for Tom's work, and now, as you guys know, Tom passed away in the last part, which is really super sad. Okay, she has a couple of days left, probably. I don't know, but she's at grade school. Damn it, I wanted her to do her work. I hope this doesn't go down. She was feeling happy when she went. That's still positive, but I just hope she doesn't go down in her grades. She is cooking up something. I think we might get Louise into her career today, because a lot of you do want her to still be a chef, and I think it's a good career option for her. You know, she has cooked a lot from even when she was a teenager, and a lot of you didn't want her to be in the business career. You just didn't see it for her. So I think we'll just have her be a chef, like I said she would. What does she need, though? Cook a gourmet meal and earn a silver at a dinner party. This is for her lifetime reward type things. Oh, look, she's still wearing her Christmas jumper, but she's still super sad. Oh, he's wearing his as well. What the heck? Why did he have bubbles on his hands? I'm confused. Right, bud, what I want you to do is go and use that. And then be funny to a sim. Okay, we can do this. Let's funny and let's try out our material on our mum, because that's what he needs to... Oh no, that's just for his satisfaction points. Oh, okay. Well, we can do that for sure. What is he actually on? Like, what level? He's not even started it. Oops. Reward trait hilarious. I want to get a reward trait. I do not focus on these whatsoever in my Let's Plays, and I really should, because I do want a reward trait for some of my sims, so I definitely need to focus a little bit more on that. Her reward trait is a fresh chef. Okay, Louise, what you can do is cook a gourmet meal. I think we'll cook... We kind of need a garden for this, because we don't have, like, any fruit. We'll cook some garlic noodles. Why not? And then I think I do want to get back to having a garden, like, plants and stuff, because ours are just... They all died, and it was terrible. This was Avery's when he was younger, but then it kind of just... I just didn't pay attention to it, and it all went downhill from there. Have you been funny to her? No, you have not. Right, funny. Tell her a funny story.
She walked
Don't talk with a Christmas tree. And she has acquired the gourmet cooking skill. Well done, Louise. So come on, Tyler, be funny. I don't know if she's gonna laugh or not. She's so sad, bless her. She looks so heartbroken. I just want to give her a big hug. She needs to read to a child for 2 hours. I kind of don't want Matriarch, though. I don't know why her lifetime wish was this, because she hates children, like, a lot. Like, she just dislikes them completely. Louise, you need to serve at a dinner party, but I want you to clean that for now. Earn silver at a dinner party event. Okay, so sometime in the future, we will definitely hold that. Why isn't this working? Like, I swear we've been funny to her. Let's do it to her. We're gonna impersonate a celebrity. I don't know if it means 5 different Sims, but if it means 5 different Sims, then it should state that, because it's just confusing otherwise. Right, come on, hopefully this will work. Let's put that in there. Come on, laugh, woman. Laugh, please. Why isn't this happening? Why isn't it saying that it worked? That's annoying. That's really annoying. Right, Emma. She's on 3 out of 4, but she needs to achieve level 10 in the painting skill and complete 5 masterpieces. Right, we're gonna stick that one up there for now. And let's do a realism painting. We'll do a large realism painting. See how that turns out for her. I doubt we're gonna complete Emma's, because she literally doesn't have that many days left, bless her. I wish she had more, but she doesn't. Tyler, you need to start working on your comedy. So why don't you continue composing a routine? You need that for your job. He should get a promotion today. Fingers crossed he'll get a promotion today, because that'll bring in more money, and we all know that we need as much money as we can get, obviously, but, like, we have quite a lot of money already, so it's not too bad. I kind of want Maya to write another book. She's gonna go ask about other magical animals to uni. Oh, and Louise is up here doing all the cleaning for us. Thanks, Louise. You cutie. Right, what else can we do with uni? No, I don't want to rename it. Oh, I meant to click on her. We can hug it. Uni looks like it's asleep right now. Oh no, it's awake. There we go. It woke up. Let's tell a secret and ask about its past. Thanks for the new follower, whoever that was. I think she can do all this because she's childish, if I remember. Yeah, she is childish. So, that's why she can talk to it and stuff. Louise, use the toilet and then you can grab a shower. I told you to use the toilet. Now do it. There we go. And I think, should we go on a date? I feel like Louise hasn't been on a date in a while. Maybe we should go on one. Maybe we'll ask Mateo, or maybe we'll hang out with Johnny. We haven't hung out with Johnny in a while. I don't know if he's gonna be a teen or an adult, but we can still hang out, right? It doesn't say what he is. And they're still boyfriend and girlfriend, so I have no idea. But I think I wanna hang out with Johnny, so we're gonna invite Johnny out. You know, they're not gonna start dating because I know that she's with Mateo and Louise is not that kind of girl. I don't know if they're gonna end up together in the future. I don't know. Johnny is busy right now. Probably still a teenager, which is kind of annoying because it means that they can't hang out because he's gonna constantly be in work. Oh, she's gonna go cry it out. Bless her. And she's feeling flirty, which is pretty much just gonna make her feel worse. Oh no, Louise just walks into her room as her mum's crying. This is heartbreaking, guys. I am not a fan of this. I don't like when Sims die, and emotions just make it even harder for me. Like, I got attached before emotions were a thing, and now seeing my Sims cry and walk around like this is so sad. Like, what the hell? Stop being so sad. Swim around sadly? What? How is that even a thing? How do you swim around sadly? I kind of don't want to see this, but I kind of do. I want to see how she's sadly swimming. Oh, she's just not going very fast and not putting in a lot of effort. And her face looks really dull. Oh, bless her, I just want to give her a big hug. Why don't you come and mourn, Tom? And someone asked for the boys to mourn because they kind of felt like they just weren't affected by it. So we're going to mourn, Tom. You, Louise, stop crying it out. You're going to dispose of this dead plant and you're going to water and weed this one because apparently this one's still alive. Oh, look, she's mourning him. Emma, I just want to give her a hug. Okay, Emma, go and dig these. This is so sad. This is breaking my heart. Is Tyler coming? Tyler, why aren't you mourning him? He's like, Emma's in the way. I can't mourn him. The grave is big enough for two of you. Like, come on, guys. You don't all have to stand in the same place. Right, Emma, stop. You're making me sad. A friend has passed. It is important to mourn and remember the good moments, good life moments had with a departed sim. You, come and mourn. Where's Maya going? Oh, I told Maya to come and dig. Oops. I meant to say Emma, but oh well. Maya, you can do it too. She's found heavy metal. She's a heavy metal lover, clearly. We're gonna look for frogs and we're gonna dig that one. What do we have out here? I kind of want Louise to order some seeds. So, Louise, I think we can order from here, but I'm not too sure. I swear we could order off here. Call the sadness hotline. Emma, you are doing that. I want to see what the sadness hotline is. I never even noticed that. She's gonna sit by the edge of the pool and call the sadness hotline. Let's see what they tell us. Oh, and Ellie's back from school. I forgot her name then. Whoops. Part 50 and I still forget my Sims names. She dug up a capsule. Open up that capsule. Did they say anything to you? Did they make you feel better at all? Therapeutic chat. A phone call with sadness professionals really helped to shift your Sim's emotional state. Not really, she's still extremely sad because she's a widow. But she's only got that for another 14 hours, which is good. Hopefully soon she'll be okay. Ellie, what I want you to do. How are you feeling? You're feeling great. So I want you to do your homework. She didn't go down any, which is good. I want to quickly check my notifications. She is a straight A student. Yes, she does feel proud. And Tyler, you do have work today. So. Oh, he's done everything he needed to do. That's good. Oh, he's crying it out too. Right, I want you to practice a comedy routine and tell some jokes. Let's get rid of those notifications and also get rid of that because he's feeling okay. He can have some garlic noodles, I guess, before he goes to work. We're gonna open this and there they are. He's gonna grab some of those. He's still in work. I think he finishes at 5, so he'll be good. Finish reading 3 books. We can definitely do that. Professional Sims can write helpful manuals about any skill they're well versed in. That's pretty cool. So, I definitely think we can finish reading 3 books. Definitely. So we're gonna read. We're gonna read Orbital Pudding. Do we not have it? Do we not? Okay. Never mind then, we're gonna buy some books. There we go. Game of Groans. That sounds really, really bad, but I'm gonna get it because, you know, Game of Thrones, freaking love it. Atlas Tugged. Can we just get, like, fantasy? Let's do that. And what else should we get? The Lord of the Swings. It's $1. Sweet, we'll get that one. And what are you? Non-fiction. We'll get Orbital Pudding. And this one. I can't even say that. I'm just gonna get a ton of stuff. I don't even know. I'm not even reading what I'm buying. I'm just gonna buy those. Thanks for ordering the books Avery purchased can be found in his inventory. Okay, but he's at work, so we can't go in his inventory. Good work, game. Good work. Right, everyone's crying it out and it's making me feel so depressed. This is not how The Sims should make you feel. The Sims should make you feel good. But everyone's just sobbing and it's not making me feel good. It's so sad. Tom, why did you have to leave? It's not okay. Everyone's just going crazy without him. What? Voodoo Backfire. The power of karma compels you to reap what you sow. I don't even know what she did, but she's gonna head on home. Yeah, I really have no clue what she wanted the voodoo to do, but it completely backfired on her. Oh, there's her little buddy. Should we go say hey to him? Should we go say hey to Zeke? Don't smash that. Seriously. Let's tell an unbelievable story and ask him to hang out with us and talk about toys and get to know him. I just want these two to become like best friends. We're gonna brag about our grades because I bet Ellie never thought she'd be a straight A student. She was like the rebellious one, but you know what? Being rebellious doesn't mean you don't have to have good grades. Like, having good grades is a plus side of being rebellious because then you're like cool and rebellious and don't really listen to many people, but you're also smart and dedicated. And that's just like the perfect balance, right? I would love to have that balance, but I just don't. I just don't. I just get distracted and don't focus on my work when I should be. I should probably be doing work right now, but I'm sat here playing Sims, recording it for you lovely people. Which isn't that bad of a deal, to be fair. I love playing this game, so you win some, you lose some. We're gonna read Game of Groans, and then I want him to continue building his rocket ship. I definitely want to get this rocket ship built before the end of this Let's Play. What thing is he in? He is a level 5 astronaut. I really just want him to get better, but he's not had a promotion in a while. We definitely need to work on getting his ideal mood to energized. I'm gonna have him like take a brisk shower in the mornings, and I'm gonna have him like stare at this thing that gives off a aura. Oh crap, he's late for work. My boss is calling, should I pick it up? Yes, and then go straight to work. Shoot. Go to work. Please go to work, Tyler. Okay, stop doing that. Answer your phone and then go to work. Shoot! Oh my god, we're like really late. Tyler, just go to work. Tyler, go! Boss, get off the phone! We're coming. Just hang up on us and we'll go, okay? There we go, he's going. Oh my god, that was so bad. I didn't even realise that it was that late. Right, what we're gonna do is talk about school, and we are going... Oh, he's embarrassed. Bless him. I want to hug him. Hug him, and I want to get a little bit mischievous. Let's monkey around with him. I don't know if he'll like it, because he's feeling rather embarrassed right now. So I don't know if he's gonna like us monkeying around with him. Oh, they just became good friends. How cute. They're like teasing each other. Oh, he didn't mind it. Okay. Become partners in crime. Do it. Become partners in crime. Come on, you two. You know you want to be partners in crime. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Ellie and Zeke are now partners in crime. They can now plan pranks together and unleash their inner mischief. Yes, this is what I wanted, but we don't have school. But hopefully they'll continue being partners in crime when they're teenagers. I really hope so, because I definitely want to focus a bit more on that, because apparently you can do really funny stuff when they're partners in crime. So hopefully they'll still be that when I age them up into teenagers tomorrow. And that is what will be happening in the next part. But I'm gonna end this part here now, guys. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like this part, please do give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to leave your comments down below. I will read any suggestions or things you may want to see in upcoming episodes. I know that we so badly need to start focusing on Avery a little bit more. It's just, I'm still obsessed with his job, but he does have the weekend off. So, maybe we'll invite Cameron round and maybe go on a date or two. Who knows? But hopefully that'll happen in the next part too. So, thank you all so much for watching and for your love of this Let's Play. I'm so glad that so many of you are enjoying The Sims 4. And also, if you got The Sims 4 for Christmas or the holidays, then I hope you're enjoying it. Because I know a lot of you on Twitter were all saying, "Look what I finally got," and I'm so glad that so many of you seem to be enjoying it. So thank you so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I will speak to you all in the next part. Bye, guys!